गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम आकाश, मैथमेटिक्स टीचर. वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन मैथमेटिक्स क्लास. टुडे वी शैल डिस्कस अबाउट द डिफरेंट टेस्ट्स फॉर डिविजिबिलिटी ऑफ नंबर्स, और वी शैल नो द डिविजिबिलिटी ऑफ नंबर्स. ओके, इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी स्टडीड द चैप्टर प्लेइंग विथ नंबर्स. टुडे वी शैल कंटिन्यू द चैप्टर एंड टुडे वील डिस्कस अबाउट डिविजिबिलिटी ऑफ नंबर्स. ओके, सो बिफोर गोइंग टू द वीडियो, प्लीज मेक श्योर यू ऑल आर यूजिंग योर हेडफोन्स फॉर बेटर क्लैरिटी, एंड प्लीज मेक श्योर यू आर हैविंग योर बुक्स एंड नोटबुक्स रेडी विथ यू, देन ओनली वी कैन प्रोसीड विथ द वीडियो. ओके, सो विदाउट डिलेइंग इन द वीडियो, लेट्स स्टार्ट आवर चैप्टर. सो टुडे वी शैल डिस्कस अबाउट डिविजिबिलिटी विथ नंबर्स. ओके, डिविजिबिलिटी विथ नंबर्स मीन्स, सपोज आई से 18, 3, व्हाट विल बी दिस? 3 × 6 = 18, the remainder became 0. Okay, suppose I write 19 / 3, okay, the remainder will not be 0. It means 18 is divisible by 3, but 19 is not divisible by 3. So that is how this is the thing that we are going to discuss. It means divisibility by which number, how to know, by just watching the number, how to know the number will be divisible with some number or not. Just like 18 is divisible by 3, right? But 19 is not divisible by 3. Okay, so let's start. First we'll discuss about divisibility with 2. Okay, now we know what are the even numbers. Even numbers are the numbers where in the unit places we have 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. These are called even numbers. So every even number is divisible by 2. Suppose I write 62, 60, 44, 38, 218, all these are divisible by 2. Suppose I write 61, okay, this is not an even number, so this will not be divisible with 2. Okay, so every even number is divisible by 2, but a odd number is not divisible by 2. Okay, now divisibility with 3. Okay, let us take an example. Suppose I write 143. Okay, suppose I write 143. To know whether a number is divisible by 3 or not, first we shall add all the digits of the number. Okay, that is 1, 4, and 3. Okay, okay, the number is 8. Is divisible by 3? 8 is not divisible by 3. So 143 is not divisible by 3. Okay, suppose I take another example. Suppose I take 147. Okay, what are the sum of the digits? 147, suppose I took. What are the sum of the digits? 145, 5 plus 7 is 12. 12. 12 is divisible by 3. So 147 is divisible by 3. So this is how you test for divisibility with 3. How? First you will add all the digits. Then if the result is divisible by 3, then the number will be divisible by 3. Okay, now let's look at how to test for the divisibility with 4. Okay, how to test with divisibility with 4. Now suppose I take a number 424. Suppose I took a number 424. Okay, now what are the last two digits? Last two digits form the number 24. Okay, now 20 is 24 divisible by 4? Yes, 24 is divisible by 4. So 424 will also be divisible by 4. Suppose 5028. What are the last two digits? Last two digits form the number 28. 28 is divisible by 4. So the total number is divisible by 4. Okay. So to test divisibility with 4, you have to take the last two digits, the number that last two digits form. Like in 5028, the last two digits form 28. So, and you have to check that number if that is divisible by 4. 28 is divisible by 4. So the total number is also divisible by 4 only. Okay. Now let us look at the divisibility with 5 and 10. Okay. Now just remember, if a number has 0 in its unit place, it means 20, 540, 320, etc. If 0 is there in the unit place, then the number will be divisible by 10 and 5 also. Okay. First, let us look at the 10. Okay. If 0 is there in the unit place, then the number will be divisible by 10. And what about 5? If in the unit place, the digit is 0 or 5, like 55, 50, 40, 35, 75, etc. Look, there is either 5 or 0 in the unit place, so all these numbers are divisible by 5. But if I write 34, then the unit place is not is neither 0 nor 5. So this is not divisible by 5. So just remember, if in the unit place the digit is 0 or 5, then anyone between 0 or 5, then the number will be divisible by 5. And if in the unit place the digit is 0, then the number will be divisible by 10. Remember, if in the unit place the digit is 5, then that will not be divisible by 10. Only if in the unit place the digit is 0, then that will be divisible by 10. Okay. Now let us come to the next divisibility test, that is divisibility by 6. Okay, divisibility by 6. Okay, to know the divisibility by 6, you have to remember the divisibility with 2 and 3. What is the divisibility with 2? It means that must be an even number. Divisibility by 3, that the sum of the digits must be divisible by 3. Okay, so if both these rules are applicable, it means if a number is divisible by both 2 and 3, remember both 2 and 3, okay, if a number is only divisible by 2 or only divisible by 3, then that will not be divisible with 6. It has to be divisible with both 2 and 3, then that will only be divisible with 6. Okay, suppose I write 144. Look, this number is divisible by 2. And this number, why divisible by 2? Because it is an even number. Okay, it is an even number. This number is also divisible by 3 also. Why? Because 1 plus 4 is 5, 5 plus 4 is 9. 9 is divisible by 2, 3. So this number is divisible, 144 is divisible with both 2 and 3. So 144 is divisible with 6. Okay. Now let us come to the next divisibility test, that is divisibility by 8. Okay, similar is the case with 8. What if a number is divisible? If a number is divisible with 8, only if, look, remind what we studied about the 4, divisibility with 4. The last two digits, okay, the last two digits, if are divisible by 4, then that is the total number is divisible by 4. Similar in case of 8, divisibility of with 8, the last 3 digits, okay, the last 3 digits are divisible by 8. Suppose I take 9216, okay, suppose I take 9216, okay, look, what are the last 3 digits? Last 3 digits constitute the number 216, and 216 is divisible with 8. Okay, 216 is divisible by 8. Okay, so 9216 will be divisible by 8. Okay, similarly, suppose I write 95216, then this will also be divisible with 8. Remember, the last 3 digits, the number formed with the last 3 digits or the unit place, 10 place and the 100 place, okay, is divisible by 8, then that will then the total number will also be divisible by 8. Okay, remember, that is the similarity between 4 and 8. In case of 4, the last 2 digits must be divisible with 4. Okay, in case of 8, the last 3 digits must be divisible with 8. Okay, so now let us look at another thing. Okay, divisibility with 3, with 9. Okay, 9 is also the same as 3. Okay, 9 is also the same as 3. Suppose I write 549. Suppose I write a number 549. Okay, remind what in the case of 3 we did. We added all the 3 digits. Okay, we added all the 3 digits. Then if the sum is divisible by 3, then the number is divisible by 3. Similarly, in case of 9, we have to add all the 3 digits, that is 5 plus 4, 9, 9 plus 9 is 18, okay. If we add all the 3 digits, then the number becomes 18. Now, 18 is divisible by 9, so 549 is also divisible by 9. So, to test the divisibility with 9, you have to add all the digits of the number. If the result of the addition becomes divisible with 9, then the total number is also divisible with 9. Okay. Now let's come to the next test, that is divisibility by 11. Okay. Divisibility by 11. So let us take an example. Suppose I write 5081. Okay. Look. The even places and odd places. Even places means the second four place, the first place, the third place. Okay, you have to add it separately. Okay, now the sum of even places. Okay, what is it? 8 plus 5 is equal to 13. Okay, similarly the sum of odd places 1 plus 0 is 1. Now you have to subtract. Subtract from the larger greater number to the smaller number. It means greater number is 13 minus smaller number is 1 is equal to 12. Now, 12, is 12 divisible by 11? No, 12 is not divisible by 11. Okay, 12 is not divisible by 11. So, 5081 is not divisible by 11. Suppose I write another example, that is 582. Okay, suppose I write 5082. Okay, now the sum of the even numbers is 8 plus 5. Okay, 8 plus 5 is 13. The sum of the odd numbers is 2 plus 0 is 2. Now if I subtract 13 minus 2, the answer will be 11. Now 11 is divisible by 11. Okay, so 5082 is divisible by 11. Okay, so similarly you can test the, now remember, if after subtraction the result becomes 0, then that will also be divisible by 11. Okay, either the subtraction becomes 0 or becomes such a number that it is divisible by 11, then it will be divisible with 11. Okay, similarly you can test any number. Okay, you can test any number for divisibility. Suppose I write a number 75,216. Now, what are the sum of even numbers? 1 and 5, that is 6. What is the sum of odd numbers? 6 plus 2, 8 plus 7 is 15. Now, 15 minus 6 is equal to 9. So, 9 is not divisible by 11. So, 75,216 is not divisible by 11. Okay, so basically you have to first find the sum of the even digits. Even digits means even place digits, that is second place, fourth place, sixth digits. Okay, then you have to find the odd place digits, then you have to subtract. If the subtraction is 0 or divisible by 11, then the number will also be divisible with 11. Okay, so this is it. These are the divisibility tests that are there in your books. Okay, now you can easily attempt the exercise 3.3. Okay, easily, and it is very fun to attempt the exercise 3.3. If there is any doubt, then I'll be there to clearing your doubts. Okay, so you attempt the exercise 3.3. okay, so we'll meet in another video. Till then, stay home, stay happy, stay healthy, and enjoy your study. Thank you very much.